Hi, welcome to my tutorial on Chopin's Etude Opus 25, number 6. In the sleeve notes of Ashkenazi's 73 recording of the Chopin studies, the writer says, number 6, with its chromatic course, is sometimes known as the Siberian, but goodness knows why. Let's guess. Imagine Siberia. You're huddled under blankets by the fire. Through the window of your log cabin, you watch the howling wind skim the tops off the snowdrifts, covering the barren, frozen landscape as far as the eye can see. If you vary the dynamics like this in the closing section, I can perhaps see how it came to have its name. Let's look at a work predating this etude Chopin is almost certain to have known, Czerny's Toccata. I imagine Chopin felt he could reinvent such a piece in his own way, perhaps less influenced by what Czerny had written, rather what he had not. I'll play the first 17 bars. Beethoven's Concerto No. 4 was written in 1807, so predates this etude by 30 years. Here are two examples of double third trills from the first movement. Grieg was born in 1843, about the time Chopin's Opus 10 were published. He wrote his piano concerto 25 years later. I'll play the chromatic double third scale, which acts as a bridge from a quixotic to lyrical section. It's most often played slowly and expressively, with a diminuendo from top to bottom, like this. In 1915, Debussy published a set of 12 etudes almost 80 years after Chopin's, which by that time had undoubtedly influenced the composer's idea of a piano etude as being something more, potentially, than merely an exercise in finger dexterity alone. Debussy, along with other impressionist artists and composers, pioneered a new inventiveness. Debussy's double third etude is at once atmospheric, harmonically complex, and full of contrasts in tempo and dynamics. I'll play you the first page. Thank you. you first start double third trills, practice need not be limited to a piano. A tabletop or sofa arm works just as well. Start slowly, speed up when you're ready. There are two fingerings for chromatic double third scales in general use, a standard and alternative. My Mikuli edition of the etudes uses mostly the alternative fingering in this piece. Before you start work, it's probably best to prepare by practicing the double third chromatic scale, the G sharp minor scale, and the B major. Once they are second nature, you're ready to begin. To help reach a faster tempo, memorise the third falling on the first note in the group of four semiquavers. Counting along with it will help keep the scale's momentum over two octaves, like this. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1. As to the best hand position for playing piano, especially thirds, over your knee and off you go. Double third trills account for about 13 bars, so once you have them, you're already 1/5 of the way into the piece. The thirds from bar 27 to 34 can be first practiced as chords. Bars 31 to 34 look tricky, but are in fact just diminished chords broken in the middle, with a third on each side sending chromatically. Practice this section as chords, then as written, again slowly at first, building up speed over time. To sum up, by practicing relevant scales, dividing the score into sections and memorising each one with slow, patient practice, you'll find this piece less daunting, rather challenging, in a fun way. Don't be overly concerned about speed. Clarity, evenness and imaginative dynamic colour are far more rewarding musically, as we know. Finally, you've got all of these things. How do I get up to tempo? Well, the answer is in the word itself. So good luck with your pieces and thanks for watching.